Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the almost monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Rob Brock, and in this edition we have an interview with Adam Szopa, Qt Creator 8 released, tip of the month, and our announcements. So, first up, we have an interview with Adam Szopa of KDE. Hi, Adam. Thank you for joining us.
My pleasure.
To start, could you tell us what's new at KDE?
Well, yes, currently we're in the process of selecting new KDE goals.
Goals, yeah. Is there anything you can tell us about them?
Oh, yeah, sure. So, the goals historically were supposed to be selected every 2 years, but because of COVID, we delayed the last batch by 1 year. So finally, this year, we'll be selecting new ones and announcing the new ones at Academy. And the goals themselves are a way to show what the community is focused on. And the process, like I said, is currently ongoing. We finished recently the submission stage where everyone could submit their ideas according to a template. And now we are in the refinement stage where people are encouraged to comment, submit changes, ask questions, etc. to make the submissions the best they can be before the voting starts later this month, at which point we'll be just waiting for the community's will to happen and the free goals with the highest number of votes will be selected and announced for at Academy, and they will be in the focus for the community for the next couple of years.
Awesome. So if people want to check out these goals and also vote, we'll have the link below the video. Also, coming up soon is your KDE Academy. What can people expect this year when they attend the event?
Well, I'm very excited about the event because this will be the first time in since the pandemic started that we will do it in person and online. The last two ones were online only, and it will be the first occasion that I will join it in person as well. So I'm very excited about that, to finally meet the people that I've worked with and communicated for the past couple of years. Finally, to see them in person. Other than seeing finally people live, there will be talks. The program has been already announced, so you can check that out. There will be buffs, workshops, training day for the community, and everyone can join either in person or online, and it's free. You just need to register on the Academy's website. Everything related to open source KDE will be talked about. And when you look at the schedule, you'll see that there's some very exciting stuff coming up.
Sounds like it's going to be a great event. We look forward to it. Thanks again for your time, Adam.
Thank you for having me. Bye.
A few weeks ago, Qt Creator 8 was released, and it comes with a number of updates, changes, and fixes. For example, the libclang-based code model fallback was removed, and it now relies on clang-d and the LSP, language server protocol, client implementation. Also, issues with the handling of JavaScript string templates and with the nullish coalescing operator were fixed. When following a symbol, what would sometimes happen is that Qt Creator opened the corresponding QML file from the build directory instead of the source directory. Well, that should be fixed. Also, improvements have been added for Python and CMake. And apart from that, two new plugins have been added. First, Coco. The code coverage analysis tool allows you to show code coverage as annotations in Qt Creator's code editor. And second, you now can browse and clone projects and connect your checkouts with a GitLab instance to receive event notifications in the version control view. Check out the complete list of changes in the release note linked below. In recent Android versions, Google decided, for a good reason, to restrict the access to your SD card. This means even if your application will have the old read or write external storage permissions declared and granted, you won't be able to freely access the SD card contents like you used to. In order to access the SD card or any other shared storage places, you'll have to use the Android Shared Storage API. The good news is that with this API, you'll be able to access any file from any storage location, like Google Drive, without any special code. There have been some basic support features for shared storage in Qt 5.13, but there have been quite a few missing features, mostly due to these missing implementation or incompatible limited Qt platform abstractions. These features were added to a new Qt 5 and 6 shared storage library for Android. The library gives you complete access to documents and other files from shared storage. Check out the details in the blog post linked below. As mentioned in the interview with Adam Szopa, KDE Akademy will happen early in October in Barcelona. It's a hybrid event, so you can also attend online, and attendance is free. Next up in September is CppCon from the 11th to the 16th September in Aurora, Colorado. It is also a hybrid event, so you can attend online. If you are looking for a C++ event in Central Europe, save the date in November. Meeting C++ will happen in Berlin from the 17th to the 19th, and registration is already open. And last but not least, if you're looking to improve your debugging and profiling skills for Qt and C++, check out the KDAB training schedule for this fall. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.